Guess what? Chuck's out again. Guess what that means? You're with me. So, welcome to the weekly update. We've got some really cool and exciting fish to show you this week, as well as a couple of customer tanks like we did last week. But first, I have to show you, we got in so much driftwood yesterday. Like, it's kind of ridiculous. Lots of really cool big pieces. Stuff that just like statement pieces that you don't see every day. We did get some smaller pieces as well and a bunch of stuff on slate. And Chase has been working hard all morning pricing all of these awesome tank decorations as well. He's got like 12 more boxes to go through, so we have a lot of new tank decorations coming in too. So make sure you stop down to the store and get everything that you need to get your tank set up and running and looking awesome. I'm gonna cut this short today, so let's go look at some fish.
Hi guys, again, welcome to the saltwater portion of the weekly update. I have so many cool things. I have a lot of hard workers for you. So I have fish that are beautiful, but also are gonna do a really good job in your tank for people that need fish to do certain things like eat algae or eat bristle worms and things like that. I always say I have a little bit for everyone, which is so true. I have fish-only fish, I have reef fish, I have nano fish, I have jumbo fish that get super huge, colorful fish. I've got, again, a little bit for legitimately everybody, and I'm very excited to show you guys. So that being said, we're gonna go take a look at some of my top picks of fish that I think are either the most beautiful, have the most color, have the most personality, and also do the best job in your tank.
All right, so I was able to get in another miniata grouper. These are one of my favorite groupers just because of their coloration. They stay that bright orange-red color, and their spots on their bodies get even more blue. Now they look black just because he's not super in the light, but they have that beautiful electric blue polka dots all over their body, and like I said, they stay that color their entire lives. Honestly, the older they get and the bigger they get, the more colorful they end up getting, which is super cool. A lot of fish, as they get older, they lose their color, but these guys just get it even better. And they are super active, as you can tell by this guy in the tank. These guys are not super aggressive as much as they are predatory. Anything that he wants to eat that will fit in his mouth, he's going to eat. So make sure that you house the miniata grouper with fish that are his size or larger. That way none of your fish become expensive snacks. But these guys are absolutely beautiful, probably the brightest fish that you could have in your tank. Just because they do eat other fish, I would recommend it be for a fish only or a fowler system, just because of his predatory nature. But like I said, this fish will be the brightest colored fish in your tank, and he will add a lot of activity to it as well.
So another fish I was finally able to get in again is this beautiful and absolutely just elegant pink tail trigger. So even though it is a trigger fish, your pink tails are actually gonna be a lot more peaceful and a lot more docile than a lot of your other trigger fish. These guys are also going to be a lot more quote unquote reef safe. These guys do a lot better at not going after your inverts, so your crabs, snails, and shrimp. So a lot of people do actually put these in their reef tanks just because it's fun to have more of a predatory type fish in your reef tank that you typically don't get to have. But like I said, these guys typically don't go after those inverts. Now it is still a trigger fish, so it always does have the potential to go after your inverts. It is just much less likely to do so. Now the pinktail trigger is, in my opinion, one of the most striking triggers just because of its black body, its bright yellow pectoral fins, that beautiful baby pink tail, the translucent dorsal fin with the black outline on it as well. These guys have so much personality. They will be up front in your tank constantly. They know their people that take care of them and feed them. Now, I always like to point out with the triggers and the puffers, because they have beaks and teeth that keep growing forever, it's important to give them things like clams on the half shell for them to wear down those teeth just so they don't become overgrown and cause problems later on. But I love the pink tails. I've never had a problem with their aggression level, and I've been able to keep them with a lot of different fish. So I finally was able to get in a fantastic number of these beautiful clown chorus wrasses, or the twin spot chorus wrasse. So these guys are the number one best bristle worm eater you can possibly ever put into your tank. Number one, top of the list. This is Chuck's favorite wrasse, one of his favorite wrasses for that reason, and it is his favorite wrasse for bristle worm issues. They are, you don't see this coloring. I mean, you really don't. That white body with the black freckles on the face, the two eye spots with the orange around the eye spot. These guys are beautiful. They do get fairly large. They can grow to about 2 feet in length. So just know that at some point they probably will outgrow whatever tank you have, but they are not super fast growers, so it will take them a little bit of time to do so. But these guys are absolutely beautiful. I really genuinely cannot get them in all that often. So I finally am able to have a good number of them here at the store, and I've got small ones and medium larges as well to fit whatever size tank. But if you're looking for a fish that does so much work for you, as well as looks beautiful, this clown chorus or twin spot chorus wrasse is gonna be the perfect addition to your tank. So I have another extra large tobacco basslet. Tobacco basslets are one of the most beautiful basslets in my opinion, just because of their lime green eyes that you see, but also that beautiful caramel colored body with the white bars that run on his lips, in between his eyes, his head, and down his back. Now, basslets are technically like a dwarf grouper, so if he wants to eat a small fish that'll fit in his mouth, he's going to. That being said, this guy's not gonna get much larger, if larger at all, so you don't have to worry about most of your fish. But if you have any super tiny ones, this guy's probably gonna eat them just because that's part of their diet. He's not mean, he's not aggressive, but he's predatory and will take advantage of that. But other than that, these guys are carnivores. They typically, like I said, are not aggressive. They can go pretty much with anything. I've had this guy for a little bit of time now, and I just wanted to point him out again just because they are so beautiful and have honestly really nice personalities as well. Up next is this beautiful masked rabbit fish. Now, this masked rabbit fish gets its name from the bar across its face, making it look like it has a mask on. These guys are venomous, as all rabbit fish are. Those top spines on the dorsal fin are where the venom is held. So just be careful when we want to do any maintenance in the tank. Also, these guys are top of the line stellar algae eaters. If you have a lot of algae in your tank and you're looking for a fish to eat it, this guy is going to be absolutely phenomenal. Just also note that they can eat your coral, as most rabbit fish typically like to do. So this guy does work better in a fish only tank, but that being said, some people have had success with them in their reef tanks as well. But again, his capability of eating algae is just absolutely phenomenal. So if you need a fish that's gonna work for you, that really has a striking facial markings just like he does, the masked rabbit fish is gonna be perfect. All right, so this little guy is being so stinking cute. This is the gumdrop goby, or the Madagascar coral crapture. So these guys are actually venomous, even though they are small. If you were to get stabbed by their top dorsal fins, it would kind of just feel like a bee sting. Their venom doesn't do a whole lot to you other than, you know, leaves a mark, makes you swell up a little bit, again, like a bee. These guys are so cute and small. Like I said, they're shaped like a little gumdrop, which is where they get the name the gumdrop goby. They have beautiful, cute little patterns. These guys only get about 2 inches in size, so they can go in tanks like the BioCube. These guys are also super peaceful. They are a very peaceful fish, and they are very easy to take care of as well. The only time that they're typically aggressive is towards other gumdrop gobies. So I would recommend him being the only gumdrop goby that you put in your tank, but they kind of hide out in the rock. They'll perch on the rock. They are absolutely adorable. As Chuck likes to say, some of your smaller gobies and blennies just look like characters out of a Dr. Seuss book. With all that personality and coloration, the gumdrop gobies are just a absolute need and stellar fish to put into your tank. All right, guys, so I do actually have a decent sized snowflake moray eel right now. He's kind of all twisted up in the rock, so he is longer than what he looks like right here in the video. But snowflake morays are beautiful. They are typically a more fish safe eel. There have been some that have gone after fish and eaten them, but generally speaking,
these guys can, for the most part, live with some of the larger, quicker moving fish, and there's typically not an issue. Snowflake morays don't get super big and they don't get super girthy either, which make them a really good tank mate for a lot of people, just knowing that a lot of people can keep these in their tanks without them outgrowing it, which is something super cool. Snowflakes are super easy to take care of. They are very hardy and a great eel, not only for experienced aquarists, but if you're new, if you're a beginner aquarist and you're ready to try an eel, a snowflake moray is gonna be probably one of the best ones that you could possibly go with. They have a lot of personality, a lot of color, and they're gonna do exactly what this guy is showing, what he's doing right now. They're gonna find a great little cave, a spot in the rock, they're gonna curl up and they're gonna hang out there. They typically only come out and swim around when it's time to eat. So if you see your eel out swimming around, he's probably letting you know that he's hungry. But these guys are just super adorable, can fit into most tanks, and they're absolutely great for the beginner aquarist as well.
I got in some more beautiful assorted leopard wrasses. Right now I have ornates, which is gonna be this beautiful one right here. I have male leopard wrasses, which are gonna be these guys right here. And I have regular female leopard wrasses as well. So I've got three different kinds of leopard wrasses in the tank at the moment, but they are absolutely beautiful. They are a very, very peaceful wrasse. They do need a very established tank though. Even though these guys do eat frozen food as well, one of the main parts of their diet are gonna be those copepods, the small little bugs that are gonna be in your water. That's really very important in their diet because these guys are hunters. What they do for the most part of the day is they swim around the tank and they hunt for those copepods. So yes, they eat frozen food, but they also need those copepods to be a part of their diet as well. That's why we recommend a very established tank for these guys. Like I said, they're very peaceful. You can put a lot of different types of leopard wrasses together like I have here and they're gonna be totally fine. They also need a thicker, softer sand bed, as these are wrasses that will bury themselves at night to sleep. They do that because in the wild, they bury themselves to hide from all those different types of carpet sharks and the nurse sharks that might want to eat them. So if you put leopard wrasses in your tank and you don't see them, but all of a sudden you see them swimming around, it's because they were just buried. So a softer, finer substrate for them. But leopard wrasses are one of the most beautiful wrasses in my opinion. You get so many different color patterns and variants with these guys that it just adds the most elegant and stunning look to any type of tank.
Hi, it's Kevin. We got a lot of new stuff in this week for freshwater fish. I'm gonna show you what I think is the cream of the crop of what we have this week.
I have in some of the cutest little peacock gudgeon gobies. These are some of the smallest specimens I've ever seen in the hobby. That being said, they came in really, really healthy and fat, and they're eating very well, despite their smaller size. Really cool addition for any nano tank.
We have in a good selection of betas this week. We have in some Nemo placots. We've got a very, very, very pretty white rim half moon beta. We have in a really nice looking twin tail beta. We've got in giant betas. We've got in some nice betas this week.
Got some really nice Gertrude rainbows in. This is a dwarf variety of rainbow, really good for a nano tank or any tank of small community fish.
I got in a nice shipment of some imported placostomus. I'm going to showcase a couple of those for you. This is a really big, fat, chubby peppermint placostomus that I got. These guys seldom reach over 6 inches. They're not going to be a very huge placostomus, but a really cool addition to your community tank.
Got in a really nice looking arabesque placostomus. These guys will stay small. This one's good sized already. They seldom reach over 4 inches. This one is my favorite. This is a Sabawe placostomus, also known as a leopard placostomus. Got awesome coloration on it. This guy won't reach over about 9 inches or so, full size. Beautiful guy. Really nice one. We got in a good looking batch of Julii Cory cats, which we have not had in a while, but these are actually tank raised, so they are going to be a little more durable for you. Excellent scavenger catfish for any community tank. Cory cats will not eat small fish, like most other catfish. We have in some Bolivian rams. These little guys are not actually true rams like your blue rams and gold rams are, but they are a dwarf cichlid. It will get just a little bit bigger than the other rams. Not very aggressive at all. I would say more docile in behavior than a crebensis, for example, so far as aggression goes. Really good fish to go in with larger community fish like large tetras and the such. We got in some gorgeous shabunkins, which are basically a calico variety of the comet goldfish. Excellent additions to your garden pond. They've got spectacular deep purple in color this week. A lot of purples in them, a lot of other deep mottled colors in them. I really like the calicos because they all look different from each other. These guys in your pond can possibly get up to about a foot long. We got in some really nice looking snow white parrots. These are actually a man-made hybrid between the man-made hybrid known as the blood parrot and a pink convict. We got in some awesome looking clown loaches this week. They came in very nice size this week. This is more of a medium size instead of the regular smaller size that we usually get. And they've got spectacular color. They look very good and healthy. Clown loaches are very highly prized as to being snail eaters. They will eat your nuisance snails out of your planted tanks if you have a snail problem. This is one way of controlling their snail population. We've got in some little pea puffers. These are also called bumblebee puffers. These little guys stay small. Be careful using tank mates because although they're tiny, they're still puffers and sometimes they may still bite other fish. We got in some really nice looking Polypterus delhazi. They are a really cool ambush predator to have in your tank. But do be careful choosing tank mates. They do get over a foot long and they will eat anything that will fit in their mouth. These guys actually are farm-raised specimens and not wild-caught specimens. They're fairly small right now. They're about 3 inches long, but like I said before, they will get really large.
Guys, thank you so much for checking out the fish. Now we're gonna have our two customer spotlight videos for this week. Daniel's gonna be showing us his reef tank, and then we have Shauna, she's gonna be showing us her betta tank. Both are absolutely stunning. Richard went through this week and decided who we were gonna feature, so these are Richard's picks for this week for a customer spotlight. Thanks again, and hope you guys enjoy.
Hey there. My name is Shauna, and this is my betta, Space Boy. He is what I believe to be a mustard gas betta, and he loves to hang out here under these roots, and he has a nice planted 10-gallon aquarium with these two cute little corydoras that are always kind of hanging out together, and this bristlenose placo here. So everybody in here lives very harmoniously together, and they make great tank mates. Eventually they're gonna get upgraded to a 30 gallon as soon as I upgrade my other aquarium to something like a 125 gallon. So here they are for now. They'll get bigger digs soon. And for now, as we see in here, we've got some driftwood, we've got anubas, we've got tiger lilies, some blue boost, some plant back there in the corner, I forget what it's called. And we've got this cool background. And the background is from aquariumvinyl.com. It is a peel and stick, and they pretty much do any custom size you'd like. They take custom orders, so if you have your own image, they can do that. And this is one I actually picked straight from their website. And of course, All these fish in this aquarium came from Fishy Business. They're all happy and healthy. And I hope this inspires someone to start their own planted betta aquarium with some tank mates. Thanks for watching.
Hello everyone, Dan Huggins here. This is my Cobalt Seaview 40 all-in-one reef tank. Got a hang-on back refugium added, a couple AI primes, wave maker, protein skimmer. That's pretty much it for this tank. Mostly soft coral, LPS. Here. Mushrooms and button scoli. I've had a lot of issues with nutrient levels in this tank. I think I'm finally starting to get on the right side of it, so I'm finally starting to see some growth and some color. Fish are always happy. So yeah, this is my tank. I hope you all enjoy it. Thank you guys for choosing me for Tank of the Week. And happy reefing, everyone.
Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. We really appreciate it. Again, come down, check out all these awesome fish that we got in, and make sure you stop and check out all the huge show pieces that we have in our Driftwood section. They're like all over the store because I got so much in. Thanks again to our customers who've been turning in photographs of their tanks and sending me videos of their tanks so that we can spotlight you in the upcoming weekly update videos. We're having a lot of fun seeing you guys' tanks at home. So make sure to keep a lookout for the Facebook posts on that for next week. Send us your tank pictures and your videos so that we can feature you. Thank you so much again. Like, subscribe, shoot us a comment if there's something that you want to see. And we will see you guys next week. Take care.